All right, here we go. So we can't put this thing together. Got all my bushings done. Got the holes drilled in. So, fire up the TIG welder.
That's gonna fall off. I went ahead and welded around that first because I don't want water to get into the tube. And once I put the skin on the back, I won't be able to get up into here. So didn't want to weld it because the odds are pulled this out of square, so we'll have to get that squared back up before we go any further. was trying to do is get this to drop in right here. I'm gonna flush. Just work it like a tree, driving wedges in. Spread it out. Because this piece is 36 inches and this piece is 36 inches, so should make a really nice fit. And I'll be able to weld right along here. So I gotta get this side in yet. I think I'm gonna put a tack over here because I like this. I like where that's sitting. I'd say that's looking pretty good. Start to come together. Still thinking about the cutting edge. What I'm gonna do for it. Got a piece of AR-500. I'm gonna have to put the sharp edge on it. Probably wait and weld those after with the pins in to make sure they can go in and out. Now we're gonna come up with space. Wide. Looks good though. This is gonna be awesome. We'll get the tractor started up. Tractor started and a little test fit before I weld it up. Almost perfect. It fits right in that groove right there. That's awesome. That's awesome. 10/26 with a 3-foot bucket. right, I gotta figure out cutting edge. Then I can weld this baby up and go play. Okay, found what I'm gonna use for a cutting edge. So what is it, an inch and a half by half cold roll steel. I wanted some AR, but I figure I'm not gonna be digging anything tough, maybe. Might work. And if I bend it, I'll do something different. This is kind of an extreme. Got the head laid at 45. Making my cutting edge. Never had the mill like this. It'd be easy to work on.